definitely nothing interesting outside. No actual books. Seamstress Mimuru says, I need someone to help me with the sewing. I must make clothes for the master in time for the party in Miyotam. Well, I guess we're not going to do that for you. The butler says, it's so busy, really busy. Perhaps we should hire part-time workers. Vanessa says, Anessa and I are always together, aren't we? Anessa says, yes, we are. I'm going to pick some flowers with Vanessa. We'll use the flowers to mix a cologne or bourion, whoever that is, we'll wear at the party on Riotam Island. Deck says, the master is attending the party in Miyotam. It's busy like hell in the house. Stop moving around so much. Eh. Okay. What's down here? Just in case, I'm not sure if there's going to be any kind of battle down here. Last time we were in an area like this, there was. Nothing down here that I can see. We haven't gone in that central room yet, either. Oh. Here we have, like, potatoes and cabbage, I guess. Look at this one, bashed. What's this, like, honey or something? Peppers or tomatoes? Rice, possibly? Hello? Oh, there's Burion. It's crazy in my house. Everyone is running around preparing for me to attend the party in Riotam. Can I find extra help if I pay 200 gens a day? Okay. Now what? Is there anywhere we haven't been? What's Gresino's place? Because I wonder if there's a door in one of these places. I think we've seen everywhere in here already, and I'm not sure what to do next. Where's Gresino's place? Oh wait, they're over there, okay. Let's go meet up with them. Xiao says, hey, Master, we've been waiting for you. I have a very good proposition for you. I guarantee you'll make money. McBain says, I thought you'd been checking if we could perform. Rachel says, well, yeah, that. The tension is not as high as what we experienced in Trim, but people here are also pretty sensitive about troubadours. Xiao says, that's why we thought we should work part-time doing something else for a change. Rachel says, there's a wealthy person called Burion in this town. They say he was invited to the party that's going to take place on Ryotam Island soon. Forte says, the party on Ryotam Island? You heard her. Una says, ah, the party Ambassador Gareno was talking about. He said that many dignitaries around the world would gather. Rachel says, oh, so you know about it already? We don't know the details, says McBean. Rachel says, this wealthy Burion person is now super busy preparing for the party. He's looking for part-time workers, and... McBain says, that's good pay. He didn't say how much. You think so too, says Xiao? Alright, it's decided then. Let's go to Burion's house at once. Hold on, McBain says. I didn't exactly say yes. Huh? Why? We are performers. Performers must earn their living by performing. But then we'll be in trouble. How come you'll be in trouble? Oh, I know. Xiao says, I promised them already. I can't go back and say no now. Here, this money is for you. Xiao took out 300 yen. This is an advance. For you, Master, Forte, and Una. McBain says, what will you do if we say no? Forte says, Grandpa, we have no choice. He got us the money already. Sorry, my father is really pushy, says Rachel. Xiao says, if we can't earn our living performing, we must do other things to make money. You've got to draw the line somewhere. Think of it as a kind of social study for you, Forte, Una. Now we should leave at once. We must go to the Burion's house. Let's go. Xiao and Rachel join the party. Okay, cool. Now that they're in the party, did these people say different things? No. We still can't perform, right? Alright, back to Burion's house. Actually, let's see if we've got any equipment for the other two now that they've joined up. That's equal to what she has. And then the hammers are for Xiao. Yeah. Alright, well, they don't have anything new. Xiao says, we'll be back soon. The butler says, you're late. Have you brought part-time workers? Sure, as promised. Five people, and a dog is an extra. They're all hard workers. Especially the dog. An elderly man and children? And a dog? Whoa! I'm guessing. From Jan. Well, we can't ask too much, but if you don't finish your job, we can't pay you the rest of the money. Let's see, you two grown men go down to the storage in the basement and carry some stuff. It's heavy work. Do you think you can handle it, old man? Don't you worry, McBain says. I take pride in my physical strength. Big girl, you work in the seamstress room at the back. She's not big. Like, you mean sewing, says Rachel. You can't sew? Of course I can. Bring it on. Alright then. Little girl. I guess one's older than the other. I mean, I guess Rachel's older. Little girl, you go and pick the flowers we need to mix a cologne. Go with the other girls. Yes, says Una. Now, people, get moving. Okay. I must get back to work, too, says the butler. Forte says, Oh, I forgot someone, butler says. And a dog. Let me think. What job can I possibly assign to a boy and a dog? Don't think too much and just give us an order, says Forte. It's so admirable of you. However, you can't do anything that requires power. Then again, I don't think you can sew either. I can run fast, says Forte. Do you have any errand to run? Well, let me see. Wait, you said you could run fast, right? Can you run faster than rats? I'm not sure. I haven't raced with them yet. Rats have been spotted in the food storage in our basement lately. I want you to get rid of them. Understood. I think we can do it. Alright, let's check on in the others first. We got sewing going on in here. Una says, I'm going to pick some flowers. You keep up with the good work too, Forte. Yeah, she said that already. We'll take Una for a while. Okay. That part-timer in the seamstress room. Do you know her name? She's my type. We could tell you, but then we'd have to kill you. Oh, you must be our new part-time workers. We have a lot of work lined up for you. I leave it to you. Have you gotten rid of the rats in the food storage in the basement? Report to me when you're done. We now have part-time workers, but things don't get done for some reason. Because all we do is walk around and talk to people. Rachel says, oh please, I get so frustrated doing embroidery. It's not that I can't do it. The needle keeps stubbing my finger at the same place. Ouch! I hate it. Oh, by the way. Yeah? What is it? Says Forte. How do you feel about Una? How do I feel about her? She's just a childhood friend. Oh, God. Men are so helpless. What? Do you need me? I hate sewing needles. You turn your attention away only for a while, and they stub your fingers. I get so frustrated doing needlework. There's a lot of things to say. She's out of stuff. Now, the food storage is there, but I want to see what's going on down here with McBain and friends. Chow? Carrying things is such a monotonous job. Blue-collar work is not for a handsome guy like me. McBain says, don't talk nonsense, just do your job. Damn you, Shao. Can't you do anything other than complain? You brought this job to us. Alright, let's go get rid of these rats then. Oops. There's the furry rats. Woo! Found a rat? Oh, you found a rat hole. Look, it's a hole, says Forte. Do you think the rats came in from here? Sniff, sniff. How's it, Jan? Can you smell a rat? Hmm. Animal's crying voice. Squeak! Oh. Did you find it?
Ruff! Ruff, ruff!
Friends.
Squeak!
So you're the rats they were talking about. You can't find any food in the forest, right? Look at all these animals. I know, Jan. You want us to let the desert rats go, right? No? Huh? You want us to give them something to eat? Like a lassie or something. What is it, girl? Oh, we gotta feed the rats, girl? Okay. But the butler will scold us if we give them food without his permission. Wait, I remembered. We can get cookies from Rachel. Wait here for a while. I'll come back with food. Until I come back, don't eat things around you, alright? They're rats. I'm gonna pay attention to you. Then we could examine the hole, but no. Alright, we gotta get the food from Rachel. Oh, the butler's over here now. Oh, Rachel moved. Young girls nowadays, none of them have patience, really. The part-time worker has quit already. Really? Rachel has quit? Says Forte. Yes, she has. She said, "This is not for me," and left. So, do you know where they are now? I have no idea. They give us such trouble leaving their jobs halfway like that. Why aren't you using she to refer to her? Alright, so I gotta go find her. Hopefully she's in here somewhere. Nobody in here now. She's not in the room anymore. Are they all down here, or they just left? Oh. Xiao left as well? Forte, what happened to your work? McBain says. Something came up. Rachel quit her job. That's right. Xiao's gone too. They found something more lucrative. What they've done barely covers the advance money. How could they? Says Forte. Without Rachel, we can't get cookies. What about cookies? Forte told McBain about the desert rats. Oh, I see. I have some cookies here. Really? Why? I guess Rachel did feel guilty after all. She left these cookies and told me to give them to you and Una. She's not such a bad person, Forte says. Hold that thought. Not a bad person doesn't run away from her work. You mean a good person doesn't run away? Forte receives cookies. Cookies always found in Rachel's pocket, popular among children and animals. I feel sorry for the desert rats. I guess they are really desperate for food. Alright, well, now we have cookies. Even though we didn't find Rachel. And Una's gone also. Just want to check around to see if any of them were ran into one of these rooms. So funny. I thought I was gonna have to fight rats. I said we're feeding rats. I was thinking back to, like, the first fight in Baldur's Gate, where you fight the rats. Oh, there it came out of the hole. Sorry to have kept you waiting. You must be hungry. He gave cookies to the desert rats. Squeak, squeak! that look a little mini mouse or mini rat? But you can't come back here, do you understand? I can give you cookies only today. You better go home now.
Chirp.
That was cute. Well, now what? Oh, we're like crawling along. Deck says, it's an emergency! What is? Butler says, what is it? It's the swing gang! The swing gang just dropped in! They took hostages and are demanding a ransom. What? So who are the hostages? The girls who went to pick flowers. Oh, Una and the other two. Vanessa and Anessa, I guess? Yeah, Vanessa, Anessa, and the part-time worker named, yes, Una. What? Una was taken too? Forte says. Dex says, Master, this is a demand letter. A nervous-looking young man left it with us. He ran away quickly, but I'm sure he was a member of the swing gang. Let me see it, says Burion. He's reading it. We have the three girls. If you want them to live, prepare 1 million gents. Bring the money to Aquaharp Cave. Have an old man or child deliver the money. If we see any strong men, we will kill the hostages immediately. Hmm. How contemptible. What should we do? Says the butler. They're asking us to send a child or old man to deliver the money. People like them can't be trusted. They might just take the money without returning the hostages and give us the second demand. I'll go, says Forte. Una is trapped. Let me go. Hold your horses, Forte, says McBain. Who is this young man? Burion says. The butler says his name is Forte. He's another part-time worker we hired. The gentleman is McBain, his grandfather. Una is my childhood friend, says Forte. Mr. Burion, please let me go. But we're talking about a bandit. I'm all right. We were going to kick the swing gang's ass anyway. I love it. Kick their ass, says Burion. It's a long story, says McBain. We're actually professional troubadours. Because of the swing gang, we can't perform anywhere, and we've been thinking about taking some action. So please leave it to us. I'm an old man, and Forte is a child. We are perfectly qualified for the delivery. Don't worry, we can fight too, see? Huh. Burion says, wow. We won't be beaten by bandits, McBain says. Certainly you meet the criteria given by the swing gang. It's awfully specific, like these are exactly the people they want. Perhaps we should accept the brave offer by Mr. McBain and Forte. How about the ransom? Butler says. No need, Forte says. We don't want to carry all that money. He's right, says McBain. To begin with, they don't have a chance getting even one gent. Such reassuring words, says Burion. Butler says the Aquaharp Cave is located south of this town. When you come to the fork, take the road east. You'll soon come to Aquaharp Cave. Okay, fork, east. You'll find the cave soon. Anessa and Vanessa are good, happy girls. I hope they are unhurt, says Deck. Burion, it's good to have people like you who are skilled in martial arts. I'm counting on you. Oh, that's Deck. He was hanging out there. He moved. Now, I don't think there's anybody left downstairs, so what happened to Shao? He wasn't taken captive, and neither was Rachel, so where are they? If we find them, Obviously, we'll have him join the party. Is it true the swing gang kidnapped Anessa and Banessa? Please rescue them quickly. And if you call one, both of them are going to think you're calling them. Yeah, there's nobody down here, okay. I wonder if anyone out in the town is saying anything different. Rough? I didn't talk to her. We've lost money this month again. Perhaps I should find some work at Mr. Burion's house. I can sew better than many people. Maureen says, "Where are you from, boy? I'm sure it's pretty tough traveling from place to place." I hear the swing gang took maids from the house. It's a terrible thing. Maids were taken from the house? I'm worried for them. So some of them are referencing the event. Hard to know who I talked to and who I didn't. Find this inn that we were at. Oh, here it is. Kidnapping? So the swing gang was not just a group of robbers. They're such barbaric rogues. Or they're roguish barbarians. Alright, let's start heading for this place then. South and then east at the fork. Arbencottle. Oh. They don't mean east here, do they? Oh. Nope. A dotted ribbon. What would that be under? Accessories? Cute ribbon with red polka dots. The stylish ribbon increases spell power. Oh, cool. I like these little hidden areas. Won't be surprised if later on they're very difficult to traverse and or find. Where I was going. How dare you? Zero damage. Gotta love it. Well, now they'll get more experience because there's only the three of them. Oops, look at a tree. Not seeing a fork yet. Maybe this is the fork. Look, it's a fork, says Forte. It's a 4K, Forte. McBain says, we must go east to get to the Aquaharp Cave. Let's hurry. What if we don't hurry? Alright, south is that way. Just curious. The previous screen... Oh, we can't go. I thought we could have gone south or east. Aquaharp Cave is east 68 milos. We're actually halfway to Cantus as now as well. That's it. Cool. We'll be starting that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.